No, no, it's quite true, I have not.
Have you never walked forth with my younger brothers, born in these later years?
No, I don't think I have. No, I haven't.
Well, I've had so many brothers, well, more than 1,800.
Oh, tremendous family to provide for. Spirit, conduct me where you will. Last night I was taken by force, but the lessons I was taught, they're working now. Tonight, if you have aught but to teach me, let me profit by it.
Well, take my robe. Do you know this house?
No, I can't say that I do.
It is the home of your employee, Bob Cratchit.
Oh.
Shall we go in?
No, 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 I don't want to disturb them.
Well, as with Christmas past, we shall be invisible and unheard.
Oh.
I wonder what's keeping your father and Tiny Tim.
Father probably stopped to speak with the parson. We'll have to speak with him about the sermon.
It smells delicious, Mother. I can't wait another minute.
But you shall have to. We can't start without your father and Tiny Tim. Go tend the fire, Peter. I wonder what's keeping our Martha. She weren't this late last year by half an hour.
Here's Martha, Mother.
Here's Martha, Mother. There's such a goose, Martha.
Yes. Hey, Mom. Why, bless your heart alive, my dear. How late you are.
We had a deal of work to finish up last night and had to clear away this morning.
Well, never mind, so long as you are here. Sit you down by the fire and have a word, Lord bless ye.
Lord, we thank you for the bounty that you have placed before us. We thank you for this day of love and joy. We thank you for this day that we get to spend together and share with each other and you. The fullness of our hearts on this special day. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
What? Did you say something?
No, 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 I said nothing. I would like to propose a toast to Mr. Scrooge, the founder of the feast.
The founder of the feast, indeed. I wish I had him here. I'd give him a piece of my mind to feast upon, and I hope he'd have a good appetite for it.
Dear, the children, it's Christmas.
It should be Christmas, upon which we drink to the health of such a odious, stingy, hard, unfeeling man is Mr. Scrooge. Nobody knows it better than you do, Robert, poor fellow.
Dear, have some charity.
Ah, well, I'll drink to his health for your sake and for the day's sake, but not for his.
to Mr. Scrooge.
Mr. Scrooge.
Mr. Scrooge.
Mr. Scrooge.
Mr. Scrooge.
Mr. Scrooge.
A Merry Christmas to us all, and God bless us.
A Merry Christmas.
Indeed.
Well, what is it?
Well, it's just that I thought my clerk Cratchit might have a bigger portion, that's all.
That's hardly likely given the wage he earns. Or should I say picks from your pocket every 25th of December?
Spirit, do not mock me further. The error of my ways is becoming all too clear to me now. Take me from this place. I've seen enough. No more.
Good as gold, and better. Somehow, he gets so thoughtful, sitting there so much. I mean, he thinks of the craziest things that you've ever thought of. He told me, on the way home today, that he'd hoped everyone at the church saw him, because he was a cripple, and that it may be some sort of pleasant reminder for them upon Christmas Day, who helped lame beggars walk, and blind men see. I do believe he's getting stronger every day. Spirit!
I'm sure you're right, Bob. I'm sure he's getting stronger. With our love, we will make him stronger.
Spirit, tell me that Tiny Tim will live. Spared.
If these shadows remain unaltered by the future, none of my race will find him here. But what then? Let's let the child die, and then it'll decrease the surplus population.
Well, you use my own words against me.
Well,